We have three people that for them, HaKadosh Baruch Hu opened, the Creator opened the sea and saved all of Am Yisrael, let them cross the sea. So one of them, he already died, it was Yosef HaTzadik, that he was righteous, so he's different, because he already passed away. By the merit of our ancestors, of Yosef HaTzadik, the sea been opened for us. Wonderful. But us, we want to be like someone, we want to learn from that situation something for ourselves. So we cannot plan and imagine that we're going to be like Yosef HaTzadik, because he is not someone to learn from, because he already passed away in that situation. His merit was standing and protecting us, but we cannot learn from him. Okay, maybe his Kedushat HaBrit, his attributes, his midot. Okay, but still, he is not an actor player. Yes. Okay, so we have another two left. One of them is Moshe Rabbeinu, and one of them is Nachshon ben Aminadav. On Moshe Rabbeinu, it's harder for us to learn from him on us, because we assume that Moshe Rabbeinu is very different than us. On Nachshon ben Aminadav, it's easier for us to learn, because who was Nachshon ben Aminadav before? Okay, a person, he was there in the public, he was part of the nation, part of the gang, and he jumped into the water. So let's try to learn from both of them. We see that Moshe Rabbeinu, he was holding his hands up in the air and he was praying to Hashem Yitbarach. So he was counting on prayers, on tefillot. He was praying. He had faith and he believed in the power of Hashem Yitbarach, that Hashem's got the power to redeem us, to open the sea, to do whatever it takes to save Am Yisrael. And he was standing and praying. He wasn't in no stress, he was relaxed, he was standing, even though the Egyptians are coming, even though there were bears and lions from both of the sides and the sea in front of them. Okay, there was a very stressful situation. Moshe Rabbeinu was standing in prayer. Okay, we understand that for us it's going to be very hard to pray.